I'm Andrew from Creative Guitar. I had a question come into the studio this week from Garrett out in Cleveland, Ohio. He wrote in saying, "Hi, Andrew. I was hoping you could follow up on something that my own guitar teacher couldn't explain to me all that well. He's a rock player, and his question is more of a fingerstyle topic. It's called Travis picking. There are some explanations I found through Google, but most of the YouTube videos I've watched are just guys playing really fast and not really explaining it very well. Hope you'll do a video on this. Thanks, and thanks for writing in, Garrett. Appreciate it. And most certainly, you know, it's a fun thing to learn how to do. Travis picking is what is most often referred to as basically a pattern picking technique. And this particular term, you know, it kind of pays respect to a famous country and western singer named Merle Travis, who enjoyed a long career that spanned over 40 years in the music business. So this technique can be used with either the thumb and the index finger, or the thumb, index, and middle fingers. And it creates a busy style that blends lines picked by the fingers and rhythmic bass patterns picked or strummed by the thumb. So because this approach is a pattern and it repeats over and over, you know, covering basically any type of chord, it actually can be performed, it can be learned to a high degree of skill and performed very fast. And it offers a really cool way of playing fingerstyle with all kinds of chord progressions. You know, there's a new Pearl Jam song called Just Breathe. It's used in that piece. There's a classic by Kansas called Dust in the Wind. You probably heard of that song. It's used in that piece as well. So what I'd like to do in this video is I want to show you a popular Travis picking pattern and how to cover 6th, 5th, and 4th string root chords, you know, like D major, C major, and G major type chords. And I'd also like to include a nice Merle Travis classic turnaround lick. So I guess, you know, without further ado, let's zoom in on the neck and get started. So what I'll have you do is start off with making a D major chord shape, just a basic D major with index, ring, and middle fingers. Then going over here to the right hand, what we're gonna do is we're going to focus for the video here on incorporating the thumb, index, and middle fingers for our traverse picking work. I know that some of the stuff that you'll see, the real old-time basic stuff, will incorporate thumb and index a lot of times, but we're gonna incorporate thumb, index, and middle. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go into this D major chord here. We're gonna start off and give you the basic idea of most popular Travis picking pattern. What's gonna do, I'm gonna get you to focus in on getting your thumb and your middle finger on the outside tones of that D chord. So we're gonna have thumb on the open fourth, and we'll have the middle finger on the second fret of the first string. We'll be hitting them together. And then we'll be going to the inside strings of the D major chord. We'll have a second fret, third string, and a third fret, second string. So together on the first two, and that's gonna be a note of an eighth note, and then we'll have 16ths after that. Okay, that's the first beat. And then on the second beat, we're going to go back individual tones here now, going to the low bass open fourth. And then we'll have the middle finger grab that second fret first string. Then we'll shift the thumb across to the third string, get that note on that string. And then index will take care of the second string, third fret tone. So we've got the together on the outside tones, working inside, then outside, one at a time, and then inside, one at a time. So it's quite a straightforward pattern, but you know, when you speed this thing up, sounds pretty cool. And especially if you, you know, really get this thing smoking fast. Sounds very cool. So that's the first pattern I'm showing you. It's basically a 4-string pattern. Now we're gonna move over to a 5-string pattern and incorporate the C major chord. So what I'd like you to start off with is just make yourself the standard C major chord first, or open position chord, whatever you want to call that one. And what we're going to do next is basically focus in on plucking initially on the outside tones. We're going to get the first string, and we'll also have the fifth string. We're going to pluck those two notes together with thumb and middle fingers. And then we'll move inside to the fourth and third strings of the C major chord. Get those one at a time. Then we're going to go to the fifth string, then to the second string, then to the fourth string, then to the third. That takes care of the first two beats of the measure. Then next, what we're gonna do is double pluck on the fifth and second strings this time, and then go on the inside notes of fourth and third strings, over to the fifth string, and then to the first string open. So we're changing things up there a little bit, and then we're going back to the fourth string, and then the third string. So we have, from the start of that measure, outermost strings of the C chord, then working our way inside, then outside again. And I'll speed that up a little bit. Okay. So that's our five-string pattern. Now, next thing I'd like you to do is go into a G major chord, but for the G major, I'm going to get you to play the bass note with your middle finger, and then get the fifth string, second fret tone, the B tone, with your index, and get the uppermost tone on the first string, third fret with your ring finger. And we're just going to get this fingering because it's going to give us a lot better chance of getting a clear fifth string B note in the chord. So let's just get into the pattern now on this. We're going to double pluck on the outermost string. So we're going to get first string and the low sixth, plucking those together, then going on the inside open strings there, fourth and third strings open. Then we're going to move over to the fifth string and then the second string, back to the fourth and the third. Then we're going to double pluck on the fifth and second strings, then work our way inside again. And then one at a time, we're going to get the bass outer string there, the sixth, and the other string up on top of the first string. And then we're going to work our way inside again. So all together from the start of that measure, it's going to go. Just like that. So you can tell when we've moved over to the sixth string and you know what we did with the fifth string layouts, we can alter the pattern a little bit. We don't have to always be playing the same string sets. And there's a lot of alterations you can make to this concept of Travis picking. So it's quite versatile. The last Travis picking idea I'm going to go through with you is a classic country and western turnaround lick, and it goes like this. So it starts off on a C major chord, typical open, you know, C major. We're going to take it from the root off fifth string, third fret, using the thumb, the right hand. Then we're going to go across to the first fret note on second string. And at that point, we're just going to backpedal across into the third string and then the fourth string. Then we're going to head up to a C sharp diminished seventh chord with the middle finger taking the fourth fret of fifth string, ring finger on the fifth fret of fourth string. Index will take the third fret of third string, and the baby finger will be up there on the second string, fifth fret. So I'll complete first measure. Then into the second measure, what we're going to do is make a G major chord with D in the bass. So it's just like a typical big G major bar chord, but we're focusing on the four inside strings. We're going to use ring finger on that fifth fret of fifth string, and then we use index, middle, and baby fingers to take care of second string and third string and fourth string, just like that on third, fourth, and fifth frets. Then what we're going to do is pluck on the first string and the sixth string together open and head over to open fourth string with the first fret played on the third string and an open second string. Just like that. Then we'll have an open fifth string A, and we're going to do a bar in the across the fourth through first strings at the fifth fret. We're going to also have the baby finger up on the seventh fret of the first string. We'll pedal back after we hit that or pluck that chord. We're going to do sort of a comping style there. Pluck that fourth string, fifth fret tone. Then we're going to add in our middle finger to kind of create a dominant seventh A sound there. Then we're going to do a full bar and catch all those fifth fret notes across from the fourth string. And what that's going to do is sort of produce an A minor seven style of sound. Drop down one fret lower to an F sharp on the fourth fret of fourth string. Sort of bring in that basically that major six sound against that A chord, and then we're going to head to another G chord, and this time it's also got a D in the bass, but it's going to be played by open fourth string, and we'll just have those upper three tones, the B, D, and G notes at fourth fret of the third string, and then we'll be barring on third fret area of both second and first strings to get that. And the last idea there is basically a lick. We're going to do a hammer-on on the third fret to fourth fret on third string. Then we're going to catch the 3rd fret of the 2nd string and head over to the 4th string 5th fret to resolve the phrase. And then we'll just strum right across a big G chord to wrap things up. So one last time, it goes like this. Well, thanks for the question, Garrett. Hopefully this clarified things for you a little bit better and for a lot of other folks, hopefully, as well, on the whole topic of Travis picking. You can head over to my website for this video lessons tab handout. The link is just in the sidebar. And once you're there, if you haven't done so already, be sure to set up a free membership account at the website. I try to post stuff, new stuff, on the site for the members area weekly. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. Keep jamming out on all this stuff, and I'll catch up with you once again real soon. Thanks. Take care.